What's up, guys? It's Aaron Nitmar. Today I have a bunch of new costumes and recolors that I have made that I think would be neat to see in Smash Ultimate if at some point we ever got some kind of color creator or just costume packs. But before we start the video, 75% of you guys are not subscribed to my channel, but you watch my videos. So if you are in that 75%, please hit that subscribe button down below. I am really close to 200,000 and I'm seeing if I can actually hit that before the end of the year. So please subscribe and help me hit that goal. So we're gonna start off with kind of a continuation from the previous video. I did a bunch of Builder Mario recolors in that video and I have a couple more based on suggestions from the comments that I think would be cool. The first one is this cool red, blue, and yellow combination of colors. Now, this is from concept art of Super Mario Maker. Before they finalized and decided on what the color scheme is going to be with the yellow overalls and the yellow construction hat, this was actually the color scheme that they had used in the actual, you know, draft for the concept art. So this, I think, is a really cool color scheme and also a really nice callback to the origins of Super Mario Maker and seeing how it actually, you know, sort of started as a beta before it became what we know it as today. The second recolor that I came up with for Builder Mario is this one, and it's based on Foreman Spike from Wrecking Crew. Now, some of you may be questioning whether or not this actually is Foreman Spike based on the color scheme, but it's from the very first art of Foreman Spike from the first Wrecking Crew before he had the new redesign where his colors are more black. I figured that Mario already had the black and gray color scheme covered because he literally has a costume that references Foreman Spike for his normal look. So with this outfit, I wanted to reference the original Foreman Spike appearance where he's brown pretty much all over and he's not actually wearing a shirt. And so I made Mario have a white shirt just to sort of cover the difference because I thought that having his shirt look like Mario's skin color would look a little weird. So I think this kind of averages it out while he's still wearing a shirt, but he looks like he's not, I guess you could say. So I just thought it would be cool to reference Foreman Spike's very first appearance. And I honestly was a little skeptical of this color scheme at first, but when I finally finished, I thought it looked really, really nice. Next, let's talk about Joker. Now in Persona 5, Joker and his friends and allies form a group called the Phantom Thieves of Heart. And Joker actually has quite a few allies join this group at one point or another throughout the game, but for his actual recolors, only one of these is referenced. While his second through fifth costumes are references to the actual color themes of Persona games, only one references a party member, which is his sixth one, and that references Crow, one of the members of the Phantom Thieves. And I thought this was kind of a shame because the members of the Phantom Thieves are literally your party in the game, and it's a shame that only one of them gets referenced. So I went ahead and took the red one, and I turned it from the Persona 5 color scheme reference into On from Persona 5. Now, I will say that I'm not entirely happy with how this came out. Mostly around the hair and the mask, I feel that it's a little bit choppy in some places, but it's kind of difficult to turn black hair into a different color and have it work out. Hair specifically on these kind of Photoshops really can cause problems. I think I did a decent job, but obviously if I had the source materials, I could do a much better job. So looking at Joker's render, it was a bit complicated. It has a lot of small, finer details, as well as the mask and the actual hair. So I wanted to pick one that I thought had a very good color scheme. A lot of them really utilize black, and so it made sense to choose one that didn't utilize black because otherwise it would be very difficult to distinguish from the normal Joker costume. On top of that, I didn't want to do Morgana because Morgana not only is a part of the taunts, but not a lot of people really like Morgana. So I wanted to pick one that I thought more people would like, and it made sense to choose one of the founding members of the Phantom Thieves. Now, I didn't want to do Morgana, like I said, and Ryuji uses quite a bit of black just like Joker does, and so that really only left On, who has a big difference in color scheme. Next, let's get to another fan request, which was Conductor Toon Link, or Spirit Engineer Toon Link, whatever you want to call him, from The Legend of Zelda Spirit Tracks. In the last video, I did an Outset Pajamas Toon Link, and people said that they wanted to see Spirit Engineer, so I went ahead and made that happen. Now, this is actually a totally different Toon Link than the one from Wind Waker and Phantom Hourglass, because Spirit Tracks takes place, you know, 100 years, 200 years, however long later. So it's actually, you know, canonically a different Link. But people really like this outfit, and personally, I do too, so I thought it would be cool to see what Ultimate Toon Link might look like in this outfit. Along with that, I did two recolors, one red one and one green one, and you may notice that this one does look a bit rougher, and that's because it's actually not the Smash Ultimate render that I photoshopped, but instead it's a Brawl model that I actually rendered out using Blender. So that's why it doesn't look exactly like the Ultimate render, because it's based on a Brawl model, which is severely lower poly, and this is just less polished because I am not on the Smash team, so I'm not a renderer. But I thought that this is a cool costume, one because it takes Link out of the traditional tunic that he has, which is something we don't see often in Smash. Again, that's something the Outset Pajamas do, but this one puts him in just another different costume. And on top of that, he uses a totally different sword, because Spirit Tracks is one of the black sheep of the Zelda franchise, and so instead of using the Master Sword like a ton of other Links, Link instead gets the Locomo Sword, which gives him unique abilities specifically made for Spirit Tracks. So I think it's pretty cool when we can see other representations of Link. In Ultimate, we have Breath of the Wild, Ocarina of Time, and Wind Waker, but this one and the Outset Pajamas all just sort of add a little bit more of the overall Zelda mythos. I mean, there's like a dozen or so Links now, and still only three are really referenced in Smash, which is more than we've had before in one game, because at most we've only had two in previous Smash games, but I just think it would be cool to have even more. Next, let's talk about Little Mac, because he has a ton of color schemes that he could pull from different characters in his game, rather than just taking them from some of his own different appearances. First up, I made a Glass Joe-ish color scheme, and I say ish because, of course, the tank top is a little different than what Glass Joe actually has, because Glass Joe is totally shirtless. But I didn't want to make it, again, sort of similar to Mario, I didn't want Little Mac's shirt to look exactly skin color, because I thought that that would look a little too weird. He's got the red and white color scheme, which is something Little Mac doesn't have in Smash Ultimate, so I thought that that would be really cool to see. I kind of matched it as best I could. Again, I'm a bit limited in having to use only Photoshop, but I think I did a pretty decent job. I actually tried to make his hair orange, but it didn't really look great, so I thought that just keeping his hair black would look good. Next, I did one on Great Tiger, and this one honestly is a very, very loose interpretation of his color scheme. I'm not the greatest when it comes to doing actual art on Photoshop, so you can see that the Great Tiger has actual tiger stripes on his shorts, but when I made the Little Mac color, I just gave him accents of brown in different places. The stripe on his shorts that's already there and his belt were all made brown, just to kind of reference that. But then his shirt and his shorts are all orange. If I were a better artist, I would actually give him the tiger stripes, but I'm just not, so we're limited. And lastly, I did a color scheme based on King Hippo, giving him the same shorts color basically, the same boxing gloves, and the same shoes. I didn't mess with the tank top this time because I learned my lesson from Glass Joe, and I figured just having his normal black tank top would work just as well as having to change it to a different color. Obviously, it's not exact because King Hippo is shirtless, as most of the fighters are in Punch-Out, but I think other than that, the color scheme works really well. It's a decent reference, and I think I really like how it looks on Little Mac. And now let's talk about Luigi. In a previous video, I made a Mr. L full costume that he could have, but this time I want to talk about something a bit more recent, and that is Gooigi in Luigi's Mansion 3. Now, I cannot take credit at all for this art of Gooigi because I am just not good enough to make this. This was made by Stephen J. Plant, and I think it's really good. It's obviously based on the Smash Ultimate render, but given a Gooigi makeover. Now, Gooigi is not literally a form that Luigi takes, but is instead some kind of living plasma creature that takes the form of Luigi, and that Luigi can control and gain access to different puzzles and different areas in the actual Luigi's Mansion 3 game. And because Gooigi is all one color, it became super easy to make recolors for them. I was able to do a full 8. None of these really have references. I think they're all just really nice looking colors, There's yellow, white, red, pink, orange, blue, and black. But I just think all of these look really cool. And I think that if a full costume was to come out and they wanted to reference something that was a bit more recent, the Guigi would be perfect for Luigi. Next, let's talk about Link. I saw a couple people in the comments of the last video saying that they wished that Dark Link wasn't the actual Link with the hat and the normal tunic, but was based on the Champion Link design. So I went ahead and made it. Now, I think of all the ones that I made for this video, this one is probably the roughest around the edges. Link has a ton of small details and things, and like I said earlier, the hair is particularly difficult to recolor for. But looking at this color scheme now, I think that it looks really, really good, and it would have been cool to see Smash Ultimate actually use the Champion's Tunic for Dark Link. I know that the one that they did use, the Tunic of the Wild, isn't actually even a reference to Breath of the Wild, because the Breath of the Wild Dark Link outfit uses the Ocarina of Time appearance. So we're already not really looking at any kind of real reference, so I think it would have been cool if this one was the Dark Link costume that they decided on. But regardless, I think Dark Link is cool no matter what, so no matter what costume they use, I'm just glad it's in the game. And lastly, let's fix this costume by making it all pink again. I don't know why they added these elements of blue. I know that they combined two costumes because they had a different idea for Ultimate, but man, I just miss all pink, entirely pink Pit, and so I decided to bring it back from Smash 4 in this video, and I think it looks really cool. I wish that it was in the actual game, but beggars can't be choosers. At least Pit has some kind of pink to work with. And that was everything that I made for this video. This was like the fourth or fifth video that I've done in this kind of series, if you could call it. So I've really gone through my paces here. And if you haven't seen the first few episodes, they're on my channel. You can definitely check them out. But I don't know what else to make at this point. So this, if you guys want to see more of this series, then absolutely leave me a comment down below telling me what recolor or what full-on costume that you think would be cool to see in one of these videos that maybe I just couldn't think of. I mean, I have my favorite characters, but I know everyone has their favorite characters, so you guys may have ideas that I just straight up have not thought of before. And with that, this video is over. If you guys enjoyed it, please be sure to hit the like button. If you're new, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Peace out, and have an awesome day.